Now we'll see the four different methods of development in detail. The first one, parallel line method. The parallel line method can be applied in the cases of the prisms and cylinders, in which the lines drawn representing the different elements of the surfaces are parallel to each other. The other name for the parallel line method is stretch out method. This is, for example, this is a square prism. Okay, the square prism has got the base is a square, top face is a square, the four lateral or vertical faces are rectangle. Okay, the size of one rectangle is the side is a side of the square and height of the solid. So you see there are four rectangles, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the base square, top face square. Okay, I said already, for this kind of prisms that ends can be omitted, the base and the top face can be omitted, but I have shown the full development here. Similarly, the cylinder is also coming under the prism category. The ends are circles, base and top face are circles. The lateral surface, it is not having any edge in between. You have to roll it, then only you get a cylindrical object. So the size of this one is, if the radius 2 pi r, the circumference of the circle, 2 pi r into h. Okay, we'll see the radial line method. This type is employed in the case of pyramids and cones, in which the true length of the slant edge or the extreme generator is used as radius. So this is a square pyramid, okay, base side b, height h. But here for drawing the orthographic views, the h is important, height of the axis height is important, but for the development, the slant edge length, true slant length, TSL, hereafter the TSL, true slant length, is very important. Okay, with you should take this true slant length on the L only, not the height of the axis height. This L is always greater than H. Okay, with L as radius, O as center, draw arc first, on it cut multiple point, four points. Okay, such that it's this radius is the side of the pyramid. Okay, so from here cutting point 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are four equilateral triangles, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you wrap it, you will get this one. So this is the base, of course. Similarly, for the cone, the vertical height of the solid should not be taken. The generator length, capital R, should be taken. This capital R is always greater than axis height. With R as radius, draw arc, and you have to find out the angle or the arc segment of the arc, angle of the segment, such that theta is equal to small r, that is the base radius, divided by capital R, that is the generator line length, into 360. So you have to find out the angle using this formula only for the cone. Triangulation method. The triangulation method is used for transition pieces. When two different sizes and shapes of pipes are joined using special pipe joint, this is known as transition piece. Transition means change. In this method, all the surfaces are divided into number of suitable triangles, opened and laid out side by side after finding the true lengths of each side of the triangle. The examples are, you see, these are called transition pieces. For example, if we take this particular object, the base is a square, the top face is a circle. So if you cut in between, it cross section is something other than the circle and the square. Okay, so for these kinds of objects and solids or shells, you should follow the triangulation method. Approximate method, the fourth method. This method is used where the surfaces of the solid are undevelopable theoretically. Solids having the double curved profile like spheres or portion of the sphere are developed by this method. There are two methods to develop the sphere. They are zone method and lune method. Zone method means you segmentize each and you cut the sphere into number of slices. So each slice can be assumed as one frustum of a cone. So develop that under first term of cone by radial line method. That by joining all those segments in a proper sequence, you will get the sphere. So that is nothing but the zone method. This is Lewin method. It's something similar to the pumpkin is the best example for the Lewin. Okay. So this one, if you take one segment of this, this is called Lewin. Okay.